We got hit by the virus that came from China. China's secrecy, deceptions, and cover-up allowed it to spread all over the world. 189 countries. And China must be held fully accountable.
With more than 130,000 American lives lost and millions of others struggling to survive financially, President Trump could soon take action to hold China accountable for COVID-19 spread in the U.S. With us now on what that might look like, White House Trade Advisor Peter Navarro. Sir, it's always good of you to join us. We see the president of the administration placing a lot of blame on China, and people are beginning to wonder when the finger pointing will stop and the consequences will start. Your thoughts?
Well, let's give it some historical context to understand what can and should be done. For the last 20 years, China has cheated in trade, and Americans lost their jobs, millions and millions and millions of jobs. President Trump was the first president to stand up to that, and one of the primary ways he's been able to recover some of those damages and defend American workers is through his tough tariff policy. So we've got China cheats, Americans lose their jobs. In this case, what we have is the Chinese Communist Party lying, going back to November when they first spawned the virus, December and January when they hid the virus, December, January, February when they were sending the virus around in aircraft to this country. So the CCP lied, and so far over 130,000 Americans have died. And I think, Trace, what's really important is we've got a lot of anger, anxiety, and fear because of the China virus out there. It's being directed against each other, but there's no party affiliation on the death certificates. This is not a domestic battle. What we need to understand is that it's China, the Chinese Communist Party, that is doing this to us. So what do we do about that? Well, first of all, let's take Hong Kong as a microcosm of that. For years, we allowed China to use Hong Kong as a way to basically exploit our financial markets and steal our jobs by using it as a platform for its unfair trade practices. Soon, President Trump has already announced in May 29th in the Rose Garden, we're going to strip every preferential treatment of Hong Kong away, which will essentially eliminate China's ability to use Hong Kong to harm us, even as we're standing up for the great people of Hong Kong who've seen their democracy crushed.
If we can, sir, get back to the consequences part of this whole thing, I'm just curious as the consequences, because White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows saying the president's going to, you know, implement some executive orders this week dealing with China, dealing with immigration and prescription drug prices. Will that executive order with China have an impact on the trade deal?
The trade deal remains intact, according to Ambassador Lighthizer and Secretary Mnuchin. We're watching very, very carefully to see whether they fulfill the items there. And to be honest, right now, the purchases are lagging, but we believe that they will catch up by the end of the year if they keep their word. But this is, Trace, this is about a lot more. You know, that trade deal wasn't really a trade deal. It was about getting China to stop stealing our intellectual property, forcing technology transfer, things like that. And we know now that even as we speak, they're trying to steal the intellectual property for vaccine development for the China virus. So again, I don't want to get ahead of the president or the chief of staff, but there will be a series of actions taken over the next several weeks that will hold China accountable for the damage that it's doing to the American people. And don't forget, even as we speak, they're waging information warfare against this country, trying to
I want to quickly get your talk on this. On June 22nd, you told this show the trade deal was over. You are asked, is it over?
I did not say that. What I said, that trust in the Chinese Communist Party with respect to that was over. So it's a case where we trust, but we verify. And unfortunately,
let me play you exactly what you said. Go ahead. I'm going to play it back for you, and you can listen to it and then respond.
Sure.
Do you think that the president sort of, I mean, he obviously really wanted to hang on to this trade deal as much as possible, and he wanted them to make good on the promises because there had been progress made on that trade deal. But given everything that's happened and all the things you just listed, is that over?
It's over, yes. And over, what I meant there clearly was that the trust in the Chinese Communist Party is over. Going forward in this relationship, they cannot be trusted. We have to hold them accountable. And that's right. What we're going to be doing with this president, who's the toughest president on the Chinese Communist Party that we've ever seen.
White House Trade Advisor Peter Navarro, always good for you to join us, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Trace.